guys, it's Full Cards here, live and direct from Montreal, Quebec, not back in Brooklyn yet. In front of me today, what the fark, what the fudge, what the frisbee, what the fleece, what the frappe, what the fennel, what the fantasy, what the fook, what the foobar, what the fickle, what the Fabergé egg, what the family, what the fish sticks, what the fuzz is this? This is a box of 2005-2006 NHL replay cards. 2005-06 is Crosby's rookie year. There ain't no Crosby in here. There is an OV in here. Base set 1 through 36. There are 36 cards in series 1. I don't know if there's a series 2. I don't think so. It's from a company called SoftMotion out of Quebec. They've been around since 1999, and they do the matériel publicitaire présentant des images animées en trois dimensions. That's what they do. So how did they get the rights from the NHLPA and the NHL? I think their cards are not regular size cards. I think they're 3x4 cards. So let's see what this box is. I've never seen it before. I defy you to find a box of this stuff. But let's see. Let's see what this is. This is really weird to me. Certainly by a company out of Quebec. I think it's supposed to be like this. Okay, guys, I have no idea what's going on with this thing and what this thing is. Let's see. So this is what these cards do, and I guess this is the size of a card. It's 3x4. It's a large card. Compare it to that, to a filler. All right, so we received that logo. So let's see what else we get. And I believe the players on the cover would be the card inside. And I don't know how many cards we get. Let's count. I just counted them, and there are 36 cards. But I believe there's also 36 cards in the set. But I believe that there would be duplicates in here, and it isn't the set. So let's see what we get. So let's first try to guess who this is. And I think that is Leech, but... And let's see if we can cut these bad boys open without destroying them. And here it is. Here would be the first card. And it's Brian Leech. And it shows two different motions. And that's what these replay cards are. And on the back, it's pretty bland, ugly. And it says Montreal, Quebec, and that's because that's the game where this picture was taken, I guess. Going around the Montreal Canadiens net. Continuing on, guys, and that would be, I believe that's Pierre Turgeon. See if we can open them this way. Yeah, I think that's the easiest. Let's see if it is Pierre Turgeon. It is indeed Pierre Turgeon. There we go. Pierre Turgeon. I guess that's a 500 goal puck. Uh-huh. Interesting. 500 goals. That would be Jose Theodore. Be careful not to cut the card. And here we go. And I think we all know about this particular game. Well, that's cool. That's pretty interesting looking. 36 cards. I should just guess roll right through them. That's Cujo, I guess. Doesn't that look like Cujo on the cover? And it is indeed Cujo. Okay. Who else do we have? That looks like Eddie the Eagle, I'd say. Particularly because we just got Cujo, so you'd think that would be next up. And it would be an Eddie the Eagle. And here would be the OV card. So this is an OV rookie card. I would gather it would be the price of this box. This box was $10, and this card would be worth that. I'm not going to open it up because I can tell it's OV, and I think I will sort of, if I do unload it, I'll unload it like this in mint condition. Who else do we have? That would be another Brian Leech. No need to open it up. There's another Jose Theodore. No need to open it up. There's another Pierre Turgeon. No need to open it up. And who is this is the question. Is that Nazzy? I'm guessing that is Nazzy. Let's see. And it is Marcus Naslund. Pretty cool. And that it would say the game is April 9, 2004. So we see where these cards are from. I guess they're from the previous season. Interesting cards. And 44 is that Bertuzzi? Let's see. And that would be Bertuzzi. And it only has, basically has two motions. So this is a company out of Quebec that I guess did sort of high tech. I think it does those ads on bus stops and so on. That's the type of stuff this company did and does. 55, Jovanovski. Jovanovski, who was a first overall, lest anybody forget. And it would be Jovanovski. And who is this? This I'm not sure. Is it Heaton? It's someone on, I think, oh no, it's, this would be, oh, it's Brandon Morrison, okay. Brandon Morrison, Aperture Diving. What a crazy little product this is. And this one here would be Trevor Linden. Continuing on, that would have to be Iggy, I'm guessing. I haven't hit, I've hit a leaf, I have not hit a hab yet, have I? And of course it's Iggy. Iggy, by the way, was drafted, what was he drafted? 11th overall, but by Dallas. A lot of people forget that, and he was involved in the Nieuwendyk trade. What's interesting about that, you'd think that Calgary won the trade, but Nieuwendyk got two other Stanley Cups. He's got three Stanley Cups with different teams. Oh, there's Kiprusoff. That's obviously Kiprusoff. It's Kiprusoff. This one here. It's Regier. This one's Regier, Robin Regier. This is Tony Amonte. I'm gathering. Here we go, Tony Amonte. Wow, a lot of Calgary players. Kind of nuts how many Calgary players. I think Regier was drafted pretty high as well, wasn't he? What was he drafted? Or was it third round? I can't recall. And there's Dion Phaneuf. This, by the way, is a rookie too. This Dion Phaneuf is a rookie card. He was quite the thing at the time. Not bad. His numbers, is, I think his career numbers are actually similar to Jovanovski's. Regier was drafted 19th overall, was Regier. And this would be Smith. Yep, Smith. Who was drafted in 1994. I think he was what? He was like 6th overall with Smith. He was definitely a high draft pick. Always thinking about the draft picks. And Pronger, right? Pronger. Doing pretty well at this guessing game. I wish I'd get some halves. It's so Edmonton and Calgary forward, this. This is Torres, I think. Yeah, this is Rafi Torres. Man, everything is Edmonton. It's just kind of slightly unfair. This is so West forward, this product, considering it's a company from Quebec. There's Sean Hornkoff. Okay, I think I'm done with opening these. I mean, it's cool. It's just like, you know, it's so duplicative and repetitive. Right. So, oh, cool. That's another OV. So it's the second OV. We can open this one. I'll open one of the OVs. The card's worth probably about $10, believe it or not. Very duplicative. Auto Betty Belfours. Wow, we have three OVs. Three OVs. That's worth the price of admission. I certainly can sell these for, I don't know, $5 each to pay for the box. Not that it matters. Yeah. So do you guys want to open one of the OVs just for the fook of it? Let's do it. Let's do it. Just make sure it goes down to the bottom. Or you know what? Can I? Yeah. I'll open it up this way. This way we can place it back in the envelope. And finally, guys, Ovi's rookie card here. And here it is. And here it is. So we received three OVs. There it is. Nice. Really beautiful card. I think these are pretty rare because I don't know. I think these boxes have probably been destroyed. I don't know what has happened to these boxes, but yeah. So there's the OV rookie card. I'll do a quick recap. To what end, I'm not sure. Okay, guys, time for the recap. So that was a bit bizarre. This is a crazy product. So we received some 36 of these cards with a ton of duplicates, including Tony Amonte. Now you can see sort of if I play with them, boom, what you get. Robin Regier, the Kipper, Iggy, who was 11th overall and was traded for Neuendijk, as I mentioned, Trevor Linden. We mostly received only people from the West. Very few Habs. I think the only Hab was Theodore, and the only Leaf was Belfour. In other words, no Sundin. Pretty cool cards. I didn't open all of them because they were so duplicative. One of the cool things, I'd say the best thing about this particular product, was the fact that we did receive the Dion Phaneuf rookie card, as well as the OV rookie card. So those would be the two rookie cards we'd be looking for. We certainly received those. In fact, not only did I receive those, I actually received a couple of extras of the OVs, which I did not open up, so I received two other of these. These are probably pretty rare cards, probably sell for about $10, though, $5, $10, considering no one's seeking this product, since no one knows that this particular product exists. I do have a stack of them that I didn't open because there were the Turgeons and, again, the Theodores, so many duplications. So that's basically it, guys. An interesting box of something I've never seen before. So I thought maybe I would pop it open, just crack-a-lack it open just for posterity. But yeah, three OV cards within this box. That's kind of cool. I have no idea where you would get these cards. Good luck with that. Please be sure to sub, like, and hashtag dry. And I'm Fucking Cards live and direct from a place called Montreal, Quebec, typically for Brooklyn, New York.